While they're going around with the offering, I'd like to call the board to come up. One up. And the pastor.
Aren't you the board?
Come on, pastor, come on up. It's your day, yes. Pastor Bennett, yes, come on up. This is one day that we get to give thanks to our pastors, and you know they study so hard just to bring us the word, you know, and thank you for all that you do.
This year we had a little bit better, and it goes for a good cause. Our three pastors, their pastor, their pastor, Ben, the pastor Ray, they do a fabulous job here at this church. Right.
Pastors, we have a little something for you, and I'm going to put a little smile on. But I wanted to thank you, Pastor Jim. I don't know where I would be, but I never met you. You're an awesome American man of God. Pastor Brian, I love you. And I don't know, I'm not a talker, so I'm good.
Just for all they've done for myself and for you guys, for the church, to see it grow over the years, and just to see this grow, this church grow into a family, more and more every day. It's a good thing, and it's all because of the pastors and leaders that they have in this church. Thank you.
Love all of my pastors, and I wanted to say that you know, sometimes Pastor Jim, he points to that bench and he says, you know, if somebody did not find him there, you know, he would not be here today. But I'm so thankful that, you know, I found him and he found me, and you know, and I found the Lord, and I would not be today. I know he would touch many, many people. They're not all here. draws us to God and points us to God and makes sure we're safe, but he does a whole lot more in rising people up to leadership. And a few weeks ago, I was at a conference and they wanted to discuss a book about breaking through the glass ceiling as a woman in ministry. And I read this whole book and I'm like, what? Because I have never felt restricted in any way to grow or to preach or to teach, but only encouragement that has made me grow and grow closer to God and have things to share with you is just an honor. So I thank you, Pastor Jim, for you know, not just the sermons and certainly the friendship. And God holds me up through him.
Amen.
Talk about an encourager and a pusher. I would have never thought of applying for my credentials, being an ordained minister, in a long time. But the pastor said I could do it. And you know what? The Lord, with his push, we even pushed the door open. I was so amazed at how fast everything went through so fast. And all the questions and everything, the Lord just blessed, and it's an honor to serve Pastor Jim, Pastor Beth, and all my brothers and sisters that are here. So thank you so much.
I think what I want to share isn't just for the pastors. I want to share about the spouses, because there's a lot that I don't want to say put up with, because that's the wrong word. There's a lot of encouragement that they do. There's a lot of, you know, like I know my husband, you know, when I'm getting ready to preach or study or do a class, you know, I bounce things off of him. He hears the sermon 40 times before you hear it. And I know that I'm sure Debbie is that for Pastor, and Jack is that for Pastor Ben. And I know Sister Ruthie, who's in the back over there, I do see you, Sister Ruthie, is that for Pastor Ray. And so it's something that, for us to be strong, it's also with our spouses, and I think for us to be able to lead and encourage you, it's not like just us or just them. They're sometimes behind the scenes a little bit more, but they're the ones lifting up, you know, I think they're the Aarons that are lifting up the arms of the Moses to make sure that they can keep going. And I know without Debbie, Pastor wouldn't be as strong as he is, because she's like that silent cheerleader that prays and encourages, and we all need that. So just for the ones behind the scenes, Sister Ruthie is a powerful little lady of God. If you don't know about that, you need to get power. Because I know I wouldn't be where I am if it wasn't for Pastor Jim. But when I first came here, it was also Pastor Ray and Sister Ruthie, who also encouraged and prayed for me. Sister Ruthie prayed a lot of prayers for me, cried a lot of tears for me. So I know that we're not here and who we are alone, but we're here because others have kind of paid the price to help us to get where we are. Amen. And it's a privilege to be here, a privilege to lead the women and be part of women's ministry. So that's all I have.
I want to thank you all for being here today. Pretty special day. Thank you to all of you. I'll share that in a few minutes. I feel like my mom is here watching me. So I love you guys. And inner city church is not like I go to big pastors' meetings and they're how many of you are running? How many are running? It's like a fish or salmon or something. How many of you are running up the stream? It changes, man. We're like an emergency room. People always here Thursday, and I think about 100 families we fed, and nobody knows that stuff, you know, only them. So people change, they move, they leave, they do well, they call me in 15, 18 years, and I did a wedding 2 weeks ago for the son of somebody who I married here 20 years ago. And that was just kind of show you, you know, that like, it goes on, and they're in a better place right now in a different neighborhood, different area. But those who stick by us and stay here with us,
Debbie and I just want you to know, as Pastor Beth, I'm sure I'm speaking to them and the other staff as well, that we just love you and appreciate you so much. And you'll know what I mean in a little bit when I get to share. We would never be here, not because of events, but because of you. And so I just want to thank you.
Mr. Heather, Pastor Ray, and I pray, Father, that you continually bless them in this walk that they lead us, and continue to bless this church, Father God, and may we not only reach the ones that are in here, but those that are on the streets that need us more than ever. Thank you, praise you, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I don't want to let the little ones go yet. In the moment, I will. I don't know if you need to turn it down a little bit or something, but I'll get self-clicked in a minute. Thank you so much for being here. Hey, this is a time of special celebration. You know, I'm so glad that I'm not glad about Matthew at the storm. Glad it didn't do as much as it could have done. It took about 500 people all in the Caribbean and some in the U.S., but mostly in the Caribbean, Haiti, stuff like that. And thank you for all those of you who took a moment to pray for the poor people that live in tents. You know, and they've been in tents for 6 years since the earthquake and all that. And so always pray for people who don't have what you have, man. I walked into a room this morning and I hit this little thing, it's just small, and maybe you have one in your house, and I hit it, and lights turned on, and then I turned a little knob, because you probably have them too, and had water come out. It was too hot, so I hit the other one, and it cooled it off, and made it warm, and I was so humbled, man, I just started crying. And I realized that even on my worst days, I have so much. So there are people in the countries that, man, they don't know what it is to go to sleep at night and feel safe or to have a street light. You know, the people in Haiti live there and at night, at about 7, 8 o'clock, maybe, when the sun goes down, they live in these cities. It's a tent city, a community of thousands and thousands of people. And at night, it just gets dark, and there's no law. People do whatever they want, you know, and we are so blessed. And that's what those third world countries are, man. You know, I've had some pastors tell me, I go to third world countries so it'll humble me and I can see what it's like. I tell them, just come down neighborhood for a week. Give it a slide. just a little bit. I mean, it's just, it'll give them a sample, you know. But I'm here today for something very special. Hal and Jackie, I don't know Hal speaks, and he can speak at men's ministries. He does very well at that. But I don't know how he does it with a bunch of people to be called up. So Jackie asked me, but I wouldn't dare only have her come up. But they were in Guatemala, right where your mom's from. And they were there, and they went, and they visited some orphanages. And we just love the fact that we can partner with them, and I want to do more with them. I always want to know that we're giving to somebody who's less fortunate. Amen? I want them to come up now and just share a couple of moments, and they have some photos. I want you to enjoy them, and I want you to know that there are people who will go to other countries, other places, where there's not a little switch and the water and all the amenities that we have. And I'm so grateful for that. Can I pray for you first, just to thank God that you're back home? And Father in heaven, I thank you for this couple, Lord. I pray for your blessing upon them, Lord. I also pray that I know I'm going to be on one of these trips down there with them. And they go and visit all these orphanages, Lord, where people, they don't even know who their mom and dad are, maybe. And I just pray that you'd be with them, that you'd let them know that we remember people who help us when we're down. We remember. They remember. They'll never forget it. And so I pray your blessing upon them. Thank you for their kind and loving hearts. Thank you for getting them there. Thank you for their ministry. And thank you for getting them home safely. Now, Father, bless our hearts in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, God. Sorry, is that on?
Try the other one.
Try it again. Oh, yeah. The switch.
So much has been said this morning here. I don't think I can stop any of that. But anyway, we're happy to be back. We've had a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful trip. However, it's good to be home.
Amen.
My husband and I visited an orphanage in Guatemala City about a week and a half ago. It was a wonderful experience. And I didn't want to go on a tangent just talking, so I wrote down what I wanted to say and to basically sum it up. I don't want to take too much time, so I'll just read. Just wanted to share a little of our experience with you on our visit to the orphanage. We were met by a wonderful young woman named Laura. She and her husband had moved to Guatemala from the States to help run this orphanage. She gave us a tour and answered many of our questions. This particular home has presently 30 children, ranging from the ages of infant to 16 years old. Although after the children have reached a certain age, I think it's around 8 years old, they should at that time be going with family who would claim them. In some cases, that's not the case. The oldest boy is 16 years old, and they don't turn away any one of those children who no one claims. On the second floor of the home are the babies from infant to about 3 years old. There were 13 children in total. The youngest, a baby, only weeks old. We did observe the children healthy and happy. Laura told us that they are fed well, and not only tortillas and frijoles, which is what most poor kids eat. From the bottom of our hearts and on behalf of the staff and children, we are so thankful and grateful for all the donations from City Limits Church. They meant so much to the lives of these little ones that of no fault of their own are in this difficult situation. Some of these children have been abandoned by their parents, left in hospitals, abused, and neglected. But the Word of God tells us this, James 1, verse 27. Religion that God our Father accepts as pure and faultless is this, to look after orphans and widows in their distress, and to keep oneself from being polluted by the world. Pure religion has nothing to do with ceremonies, temples, or special days. Pure religion means practicing God's word and sharing it with others through speech,
service, and separation from the world. God first gave, and therefore it has always been his heart to give as the body of Christ. My husband and I are committing on sending a box at least twice a year. We would like to send one for this Christmas. It will bring so much joy to those little ones. If anyone is interested in donating, please see me after service, and I will give you a list of the items most needed. And again, many, many thanks for being a part of something so special and dear to the heart of God. Please keep these children and all those around the world and our country that society has abandoned in prayer. They are loved, and God made no mistake in creating each one. They are special and have a purpose in life. Thank you. Although on the pictures it looks small, but it's actually big, and there was a lot of things in there. Laura told us that when I had asked her, I said, you know, what is the most need here? Well, you know, so that we can know and send the things that are most needed. And she said that they accept everything. And the things that they don't or are not going to be able to use, they give to the women that work there so they can sell them and make a few dollars. I do want to say that the women that work there, my hats go off to them. Imagine having 30 children, a lot of them toddlers, and they're all over the place. And these women, I mean, they work diligent, they're committed, it's just an experience to see. And I just want to say, when I walked in there, I felt this overwhelming desire to cry. I had to hold myself because the thought that these children don't have a mother to embrace them was heartbreaking. My father's wife picked up one of the babies, and she said she felt the same exact way, because think about it. We are so fortunate, all of us here, who have parents and mothers and fathers that love us. These babies, some of them are not held. They're kept in these cribs probably most of the day, because although these workers work diligently and hard, they can't pick up every child. They can't. They don't have the time for that. They're busy feeding them and changing them. So it's hard. So to see that was so humbling. And I was so thankful that I had a mother and a dad that loved me. Because the thought, like I said, to see these babies, some of them, like I said, not held, was heartbreaking. So keep them in prayer. The organization called Fatima Children's Home, and just all the children around the world that have been abandoned, that have been abandoned in our orphans. So again, I want to thank you, church, for every little thing you gave. And for those that didn't, your prayers were so welcome. So I thank you, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart.
I just wanted to let you know that the women who work there, they're employed. There's maybe a handful, maybe five or six, but they work there 24 hours a day. They live there. If you look at the pictures, there's the bunk beds, and then there's a sheet over the couch that holds over. It's like a futon. They live there. These infants have to be cared for 24 hours a day. So, but all the kids are very happy. They're very receptive to visitors. You can see that they're very chubby, they're strong, they're spicy. Because you can tell, and it's not about going away. It's not about going away to Guatemala. It's not about going to East Europe, Asia. We could start here. I'm sure there's an orphanage here. But we have to be open. We have to be available. Allow God to speak to your heart. Well, I mean, that's what God put in our heart. I don't know what he puts in your heart. Everybody has talents that he has given, and he orders our steps, and he always walks before us. So I pray that each and every one of us try to get closer to God and to find out really what our plan is, what his plan is for us. So I challenge you on that. Amen. God bless you. Thank you for everything. I'm so thankful. You don't know how far it's going to go, all the power. powdered milk and everything, the oatmeal, it's fantastic. The baby formula, I mean, we put so much stuff in there, they just don't know how to thank us. And I just wanted to reiterate that and make sure that you guys know that. I am we thank you. Thank you. And have a
amen. Thank you for sharing that. I think sometimes we do get stuck in our own world, and we know that there's people suffering in other countries, and we see pictures and all these things, but to hear the experiences and to go along with the pictures, I think it makes it more powerful. So I think we need to check with Jackie then and see what things we can maybe collect for that December shipment before Christmas. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So at this time, we are going to dismiss the kids, kindergarten through five, grade five, not age five. Teachers are in the back, and we're getting ready to go. Amen. All right. Thank you, you guys, and all our teachers that take care of our kiddos and tell them about Jesus and love on them. All right, real quick, I feel like I should have like theme music because the song I had in my head, this is a worldly song, sorry, but there's a commercial for a microwave and it's like, it's the final countdown. That's how I feel about women's ministry. It's like the final countdown. If you want to go on our conference, you need to book our hotels by tomorrow because on the 11th, they are releasing them back to the public. If there's anyone else who wants to go, we have a room block. From last time I heard, I think there were four rooms left, and that was last week, so somebody may have booked them. But if you are interested in going, we need to call, you need to get your roommates, and that really doesn't give you much time. So we've been announcing this for a while, but this is the end. So if you would like to go, you need to kind of get that organized by tomorrow. And if you are going and you are registering, I just registered last week. Our registration is until October 17th. So you have one more week to register at $60. For the weekend pass, it's $35 for seniors, singles, and students. And if you do not pre-register, you can register at the door, but it's an additional $5. I know some of our women are just driving down for the day. That's fine as well. And I think Deaconess Liz is one of those. Liz, you're going down. The spiritually satisfied woman is tomorrow's lesson. 6:30.
Praise the Lord. I only got 2 minutes real quick. For all our guests that are here this morning, we have a welcome to City Limits. We need your information, who you are, your phone address. Promise we will not give it to anybody. So fill it out and turn it in to either me or Sister Ruth, please. We'd like to know who you are. Okay, so one more thing is important. Men's breakfast, Saturday. Guys, amen. Be there. You got to be there. We got a terrific lesson that's going on. The lesson is how to be God's man in the face of temptation. And that is a tough thing to go through, too. We suffer a lot of temptation, but right now it's going to be hell at the Timothy House across the way. So invite other men, guys. And women, encourage your husbands to go. Thank you. Pastor? Hold it, one more thing.
We have a luncheon today in honor of the pastor, so please stay. It's a free luncheon. We'd love to have you come back.